Tonight, a new study is shining a light on the far-reaching health impacts from Canadian wildfire smoke.
This year, we've experienced 26 days with unhealthy air alerts because of that smoke. That's according to state health experts. And take a look at this map. It shows hundreds of wildfires burning right now in Canada, including many to our north in Manitoba. The red and purple dots are fires that are out of control, blue under control, yellow being held, and orange dots are fires burning in the U.S. right now.
Researchers told our Eric Chaloux they were surprised where the toxic air traveled. Eric.
Lindsay and Kevin, I want to show you one of our tower cameras. This is a skyline shot where you should be able to see downtown Minneapolis, but the skyline, as you can see, filled with clouds from a storm. Now, during the summer, there were days you couldn't see that skyline due to the thick Canadian wildfire smoke. Researchers say they found enormous and far-reaching pollution from the wildfires. I also spoke with a mother who has felt the pain from these fires.
Carter was incredible.
Back in 2023, Amber Vices, her 9-year-old son Carter, died from an asthma attack exacerbated by wildfire smoke while at camp in British Columbia.
He could tell stories like nobody's business, the longest stories you could ever imagine. And there were times that we were like, come on, Carter, just get to the point. And now to say that I miss those stories is the understatement of the universe.
We knew that the smoke travels, you know, thousands of miles. What I don't think we really appreciated was actually the impact that it would have.
Michael Brower is part of the research team that just published a new study examining the health impacts of the worst wildfire season in Canada's history back in 2023. Based on air samples and other data collected, researchers estimate 82,000 chronic deaths globally attributed to the toxic smoke. Researchers say that includes people with pre-existing conditions like lung and heart problems and those without, as smoke impacts other health issues.
More of those are actually occurring in the U.S. than in Canada, even though the fires were actually started in Canada. And that's just because that smoke drifted over really densely populated areas.
Researchers found pollutants beyond North America.
Certainly in Minneapolis, like you saw it, but also we found actually that smoke traveled as far as Europe and had measurable impacts on air quality and on health. I firmly believe that we can learn how to live with this smoke in a way that doesn't have these impacts on health.
Brower mentioned that his Canadian community has adapted by building clean air shelters.
We're also doing some DIY workshops.
To protect others, Carter's family is helping to build air quality monitors.
People have to realize that it can go from 0 to 100 in the blink of an eye.
Canadian wildfire experts say drought and lightning are the leading causes of those fires. And unless that changes, we could see more wildfire smoke next summer. Remember, you can always download the KSTP mobile app where you can get those air quality alerts.